Susan takes you down to a place near the river. You can hear the boats go by and spend the night beside her.
She's around here somewhere, somewhere here she's hid. Somewhere in a canal by Camden Town, underneath a bridge. That's where he said he put her bits and bobs straight after what he did. Every time I pass the lock, I stop and wonder where she is. You see, Suzanne was quite a looker, quite tasty for a high street hooker. She had a nice shape, nice ass, nice breasts, I guess that's why he took her. But then again, you know what, blood, this guy was kinda mess. So Suzanne's death was probably more to do with torture than it was to do with sex. Nevertheless, he was a sick cunt that ain't no doubt about that. His mental health was in a state, but no one really knew about that, cause he lived alone all on his own and never spoke to neighbours. Plus the guys next door was never home, cause they was always out raving, which made it pretty convenient. Couldn't have dished out penny, weren't lenient. Still no one could hear her screaming when her blood started squirting on the ceiling and drying to the roof till the paint started peeling. And she's cut real bad but still breathing and begging him to stop, but he won't cause he's evil and he ain't about to start reasoning.
Suzanne takes you down, down, takes you down to her place near the river, river, near the river.
It's 10 o'clock on a Friday night. Susan don't know it, but soon she'll die. She's working the streets like she does every night, pulling in punters left and right. She sees one guy, he says, hi, do you wanna fuck? Only if the price is right, Suzanne says with a smile on her face. Screen goes blank, now the back at his place, back at his place. Suzanne takes off her clothes while he makes up a drink in the kitchen. That's what she's thinking when she hears metal objects clinking. Need any help, she says loud and clear, he don't answer her back. He's only in the next room, it's not like he can't hear. Why's it going on like that? Suzanne picks up a towel to cover her breasts and on, and goes to sees what I want. Suzanne screams, so shocked at what she's just seen. He's holding a knife in his hand and grog. Sue makes a run for the door but it's locked. Slice, 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 chop, chop, chop. Suzanne screaming, begging him to stop, but he won't stop, and he don't stop, not till she stops struggling. She's lying on the floor in a pool of blood. He goes in the upper room to get something.